make sure the supplies get delivered to Burnett. We need to do what we can for his casualties, but we can't lose any more time. You've got Earlson up off its knees, and we have to capitalize and hit the police station. The prisoners are our only lead on Walker. You proved you're a capable man, Brady. I know you can do this.
This is a zero-tolerance zone.
the supplies get delivered to Burnett. We need to do what we can for his casualties, but we can't lose any more time. You've got Earlson up off its knees, and we have to capitalize and hit the police stations. The prisoners are our only lead on Walker. You've proved you're a capable man, Brady. I know you can do this.
If my mom's on the mail, she'd probably complain about the state of my hair.
Resistance doesn't simply mean gutting down a Nork patrol. It's about drawing a line in the sand. And no more. And it starts with a little thing.
When you pass a Nork soldier patrolling our neighborhood, like run fast.
Hold your head. Don't let your mind land in all the other stuff like a wounded puppy. Stand tall. Sleep better. They'll shout at you. The worst case scenario, they may not be up. But imagine what you gave from it. You won't be there.
Okay.
Say
we go for it.
And damn, that doesn't feel good. They tell us all sorts of education camps. Training with the very best teacher. Learning skills from one day to know. Everything we know about the North, about the way they treat us. I think they're getting there. They're turning all our beautiful children into drones, brainwashing them, teaching them to do their bidding without question. Worst case scenario, God only knows. Resistance doesn't simply mean gutting down your control. It's about drawing a line in the sand, saying no more. And it starts with a little thing. When you pass a Nork soldier patrolling your neighborhood, hold your head up. Don't let your body language fall in on itself like a wounded puppy. Stand tall. Sleep there up. Don't shout at them. The worst case scenario, you may not be able to. But imagine what you gave from it. You won't be that bitch anymore. And damn, that doesn't feel good.
Walker's gone too. Why would they do this? Did they know we were coming? God, what a mess. Look, don't blame yourself, Brady. You did everything you could. At least we got Earlston behind us. You better head to the subway when you can. Parrish wants to see you. Hopefully, he'll know what to do next.
Chalk it up!
Brady, it's Burnett. I'm sorry about Ned's men. Their murder violates every convention on the treatment of prisoners. But it means you caused all this bloodshed for nothing. At least the supplies you got me let me treat a lot of people. They won't get a chance to thank you, so I'm doing it for them. But ask yourself,